So now we will see how this BGP table works, and first we'll see what are the contents of the BGP table, right? So this is how you will see the BGP table, and what is the command you use? Show IP BGP. You will be very much confused. Why? Because if you want to check the neighbors, is just very extend to this. So IP BGP summary to check the neighbors, and in order to check the BGP table, just the command show IP BGP, and this will show you the BGP table here. And when you have given this show IP BGP, my router here shows first what is the table version, BGP table version of my router, then what is my router ID. And here first I have got the network, then what is the next hop of my network, I mean whatever the network I am receiving from my neighbor, what is the next hop, and then I have got my metric, local preference, weight, path. This is the network, next hop, metric is med. Okay, for now don't see all these. In simple term, these are called path attributes. These are some path attributes that are listed in the BGP table. In brief, right? If you go for a detailed view of the network in the BGP table, then you will be having all the network information in the network. But in summary, it shows only these three: metric, local preference, weight, and the path attribute. And the AS path. Clear? Right. First, before network, I have two symbols. One is star and the other is greater than symbol. This star means that whatever the network it is representing, this network is a valid. What is it?
Valid network.
Now, what is the meaning of a valid network in BGP? A network whose next hop is reachable via me. A network whose next hop is reachable via me. If I know that next hop which I received with that particular network, then I will mark it as star. And that network is a valid network. Okay. Next one is greater than symbol. This means the network is best, or that particular path is the best. And if you see here, I am actually receiving this 10.1.0.0/24. One is 0.0 and the other is 10.1.0.2. For now, what is this? We'll discuss later, but this shows that I am receiving this network in two ways, two means, right? But out of these two, which one is the best? Why? Because BGP supports only single path, single best path. When I am receiving multiple paths, I should pick one the best, and I will mark it with this greater than symbol. So when I'm receiving this particular network from multiple sources, out of that I should pick only one. And if I am picking one, how will I tell my network admin that out of these networks, which path I am preferring the best? How will BGP router tell us? With a greater than symbol. And until and unless you do multipathing, you will see whatever the network, from whatever the number of sources it is receiving, router will have only single greater than symbol for that network. Yeah. And if you are having multipathing, then whatever the number. If I am having 2, 3, for 2, 3 networks, it will be the best. It will be the greater than symbol. Right? Yeah. And now next hop. Under the next hop, I have 0.0.0.0. 10.1.0.2. Yes, 0, 0, 0 means that this particular network, whatever the 10.1.0.0, is added to BGP by me. I have generated the network. Or I am the source who have added this information into BGP. Yeah. If I am adding the network to BGP table, then it will be 0.0.0.0. And 10.1.0.2 means that I am receiving this network, and for that network 10.1.0.2 is one instance. Are you understand? First thing is 0.0.0 means that I have added this network, and 10.1.0.2 means that someone is giving me the network. If it is other than 0, whatever it could be, it means that I am receiving from someone else. And the next one is metric, local reference, where don't observe all this. Now, in the left, far left, you can see three symbols actually. One is a star, other is greater than symbol, and one is I. I means that I have received this network from an IBGP neighbor. IBGP neighbor. Yeah. If now you may ask here, there is no I here. This means that I didn't receive this particular path 0000 next door from anyone. I myself have added it. Yeah. Now if you see nothing here, and if it is other than 0, that means that I have received it from some EBGP network. So that is the meaning of this I. And under this path, these are actually the AS. Those are actually the AS. Whatever the last AS you are having from your left, the last AS from your left, for suppose in this example here of for this network 10.97.97.0, I have two AS telling that 64999, 64998 and 64997. This means that first this network belongs to this particular AS 64997. And some router has given that network from 64997 to 64998 AS number, and then I have received this into my AS. Understanding it? This means that if I want to go to this 10.97.97.0, first I will get into 64998 AS, then I have to enter into 64997 where the network is existing. Yeah. So for suppose I am receiving 1111, it is passing through 100, 200, 300, and it has come to 400. Now when R1 is giving that information to R2, it will check, yes, this is 1111. This is my own network, and I am giving it to AS200. He is an eBGP neighbor. I will give that information 1111, but with AS number 100. And when my R2 receives it, it makes entry in its BGP table that it is directly connected to AS100, so it will make it as 100 entry. And when it wants to give it to 3, 1.1.1.1, first 200 and then 100. So whatever the new AS that are need to be added, that will be added to the left. Yeah. And whatever the last AS is existing, that is the actual AS where the network is generated.